Hi, how is it going with your living? This is now the timeless view of my digital paintings. Honestly, it's been 3 days that I didn't want my tones by reading every single sentence from English articles and poem. Yeah, this is the only way to improve my speaking. In my previous video, how I paint water surface, I just added the background soundtrack as I have no idea what to say. But now, no excuses. I kinda like to read some poems by Sarah King. You know, I wanna explain about this hour in video, but it's just boring. Okay, let's start it. 1, 2, and 4. This is my favorite poem of Sarah King. This is the poem from the book, which is called No Matter the Rages. It's probably buying a right bloody book. It's called Postcard. Postcard. I have already fallen in love with far too many postage stamps. When you appear on my doorstep, wearing nothing but a postcard prospect, no peer is the wrong word. Is that a word for a sucker punching somewhere in the heart? Is that a word for you when you're sitting at the bottom of a roller coaster? And you realize the climb is coming, that you know what the climbs mean, that you can already feel the flip in your stomach from the fall. Before you have even moved, is there a wall for that? There should be. You can only fit so many words in a postcard, only so many in a phone call, only so many into space. Before you forget that words are sometimes used for things other than feeling emptiness. It is hard to build a body out of words. I have tried, we both have tried. Instead of laying your head on my chest, I tell you about the boy who lives downstairs, who stay up all night playing his drum set. The neighbor has complained. They are busy till tomorrow. But he keep on trembling through the night. Combined, I think that project makes perfect. Instead of holding my hand, you tell me about the sandwich you made for lunch. The way the picker fits so perfectly against the ledges. Practice does not make perfect. Practice makes permanent. Repeat the same mistakes over and over, and you don't get any closer to Carnegie Hall. Even I know that. Repeat the same mistakes over and over, and you don't get any closer. You'll never get any closer. Is there a wall for the moment you win? Touch your wall. When the weight gives, and all the extra road comes hurtling towards you, how even though you have won, you stay and with end up with muddy knees and bend on your hands. Is there a word for that? I wish there was. I would have said it. When we were finally alone together on your couch, neither one of us with anything left to say. Stay now, I sent letter into space. Hoping that some maidman somewhere would track you down and recognize you from the description in my poem. He will place the stack of them in your hands and tell you, there is a girl who still writes you. She doesn't know how not to. And the next poem is called Dragons. And please let me know in the comments about that. It is legal to read poems without the writer permission. I hope so. Dragons. My father and brother were born with canovapis. Avalanche tongue. They know how to light flame to the smallest ingestion. How to erupt into firework from the inside. The silence anger too. They are capable of keeping the engine humming. The deep vibration of furry one underneath. Me? I was not born with enough fury. My anger often melt into sadness. It would just disintegrate into shame or fear. My clenched tear relief into cheddar. But you have found the right mix of arrogance and alcohol. Place your hands on me one more time. Dance again. It hates the secret into my eyes. Tell me again how I'm just not understanding the point. Remind me how you are an expert. Touch my knee, my thigh, my lower back. Ignore me twice, three times, continue talking over me with the man to my right. There is a beast in my vein that was birthed by my father. It's quiet. It sleeps through most night. Tonight, sir, my tea twitches in the dragon's cave. Be careful, darling. Your footstep lands heavy here. Your racket will wake the dragons. How do you think? I think it is a beautiful poem. This poem is called The Letter. I like this poem because I can relate it. I can relate the writer. The Letter. Whenever I hurt myself, my mother said, it's the universe way of telling me to slow down. She also tell me to put some coconut oil on it. It doesn't matter what it is. She often hides stones underneath my pillow when I come home for the weekend. The stones are formulas for sweet dreams and clarity. I dig them out from the sheet. She tell me what each one is for. My dog hurts, so she grind black pepper into a spoonful of honey. Makes me eat the entire thing. My mother knows how to tie knot like a ship captain, but doesn't know how I got that sailor mouth. She falls asleep in front of the TV, only until I turn up. Shouts, I was watching that. The sourdough she baked on Friday is older than I am. She sneaks back and forth across the gantry. When she flies by putting the starter in a small container next to a bed of carrot. They think it's ranch dressing. She giggles. She makes tea by hand. Nadia, slippery yam, turmeric, cinnamon. My mother is a recipe for one throat and belly laugh. Once, she fell off a ladder when I was 3. She said all she was worried about was my fate as I watched her fall. Thank you for watching this entire video. See you next time.